Hi guys, today working with Sam again, and we're going to learn some stuff, do some writing.
Very good, Ron. You're being very patient. So, Sam, that's getting a nice sense of connection there. Wonderful. That we are, and you didn't know too, we're not going to tie him up. We're going to try to be as relaxed as we can.
Sam is not a kicker.
No, he's not, is he?
That's what I heard Nick say.
No, actually, most of our horses aren't. Yeah, we tried to work on that relationship so that they don't kick. I mean, a lot of people say you should never stand back there. Well, if you have a kicking horse, maybe you should stand. But if you established a relationship of trust and love and respect, you haven't hit your horse with a 2x4 or misused him and abused him, then notice what we have here. See that? That's going to be your reins, and this is mine, should I choose to accept it. We'll be there once we get you up in the saddle.
Oh, yeah.
But we're also going to walk. Enjoy all that and let that come in and become the horse. And instead of being so focused, which we always are, and our mind's going on whatever's out there, and then focus on getting on him and riding him, we want to focus on the relationship and relaxation and becoming like the horse. Instead of the predatory look that we have and the thought, we want to see in terms of pictures.
The way of the horse.
The way of the horse. Now, you know, horses are not a verbal animals as much as we are. They make verbal communication with each other. But most everything is based on pictures and nonverbal communication, body signs, things like that. They've been relying on their senses. They're keen.
They touch each other a lot.
Yeah. Connection. So their senses are very, that's why I encourage you when you brush to put your hand into it. And now we want to become the horse as far as our sight, as best we can. We can never see as well as they do, hear as well as they do, or have our sense of smell. But they do hear in the same range that we do. My understanding is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, but it's just more magnified. So we want to do like the horse right now, seeing things. Whatever we can around us, being aware as much as we can. Our peripheral vision isn't as great as ours. I think ours is about 200. Theirs is almost a full 360. But we can do that, soften our eyes so we can see each other. See Shasta out there, the minis, anything that we can. Feel the sun, whatever smells that you smell. Whatever you hear, birds, vehicle coming. Truck coming over here. Kind of stay in that part and breathe, okay? Now, Sam has not come over to us, so what he's kind of saying is, about those things that you hung up over there, which is okay, because they're new things. And horses move to things that are different, they're moving to curiosity, because they're a very curious animal. But what we want to do is we want to say, well, Sam, we're here too, and we want to be a part of this.
So graceful.
Well, Sam, I'm a little stiff today, but I'm doing okay. I didn't get to my stretches yet.
Still is
my
a neat
yoga thing.
It's a neat thing.
Oh, thank you. Come on in, Sam. We encourage you to come in. Now, what I'm going to do is just go over and take his plate.
Hey, Sam.
Hello, Sam.
Got his attention.
That's all. Good boy.
You just walked over and he stepped out of the way. You took his place.
I took his place. I assumed a leadership position and asked him to move and took his place just so that we have him connected and have him a part of us. Okay? I'm thinking in terms of us and the relationship. Look at the bunny go. Look at the bunny.
He's just licking.
Did you see the bunny? Just
too fast for me.
He's not nibbling.
Maybe it'll be on the video whether I saw
it. Sam's looking at something.
Well, the bunny just ran by.
Uh-huh.
Lickety-split jackrabbit.
Yeah.
Down there. Good boy, Sam. Okay, so we can stand on up.
All right.
Let's walk on over here. Connected with it. Next time, I won't take the time now, but next time, whenever we have our next time, I'm going to encourage you to do that. And then we try to work with all the horses like this, so if you do go off, reins, whatever, down to the ground, the horse will stop. The horse will go running off down the road. The horse will actually be tethered and stop. Okay. Alrighty, so here we go. Checking it out. Yeah, that's pretty good. And then notice, Ron, that just like remember Nick had, you always have the stirrups up on over it, so that as you put it on, it's not in the way. It doesn't get underneath. And you just lift it up, put it on. Yep. Terry's the Western saddle expert. Terry, do you like where I have him? Okay. Okay. And then remember, this has the double stuff on it, because Nick does a back a bucking strap. But we always do the front strap first, then the bucking strap. Up, 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 go, baby, right there. Boy. I'm not sweaty. Good boy. So what we do too, Terry, can I don't put that?
Do it and then
yeah. Hold on just a second. Yeah. Then what we do that's different, step out of the way if you will. Oh yeah, we'll get the bucking strap. I'll show you what I do. Something that I don't see too many folks do. Actually a lot of folks do, but instead of just tightening it up real tight the first time, snug it up a little bit because horses will blow up and stay that way. Keep their chest big.
Mm-hmm.
And then now as they get riding,
they relax
and then boop.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay, so what we do, and to get used to the horse and you with them again once the saddle's on, is do it to the first notch there and then walk
notice
the
horse.
What happens right there when I pull that.
Ah, yeah.
The skin that comes out.
Yeah.
See that right in there?
Yeah.
Good boy, go right there. That's just to give more stretch, especially if you're in the foot. Good boy. Good boy. See, just help stretch him out, I guess. We're going to do something, stretch out. Okay, so now we're going to walk a little bit. Remember how we do the walk? Not quite matching it, but that's all right. And up. Up and over. Say walk on.
Okay. Walk.
Bring that head around. There you go. Then we'll check the saddle again.
Yep. He avoided it by half, by chance. There we go.
Oh. Yeah, see if you can get him to go straight down the center of it.
Okay.
Okay, now
a little bit looser.
I did it earlier.
A little more rein on the right there hand. There you go. And up and over.
Well, no, you have to go over too.
See if you can. Can you see it okay to go right down the center of it?
We'll try it.
Okay, try it right down the center.
Show him the way.
You will?
No. Oh. What are you doing?
Okay. Okay.
Just walk straight across it yourself.
Let's go.
There you go. Well, almost.
Okay, I think that's pretty good. He seems to be pretty well connected with you. Yes, Mr. Sam.
It's a little easier with that stirrup, huh?
Yeah, you just gotta relax. Find a comfortable spot, okay? That's what I'm doing. Now, notice too, I really felt it on my tailbone. I mean, on my butt bones there, the pelvic bone. And that I don't on an English saddle, left and right. Yeah. So you get a nice center. There you go.
Okay.
Now support yourself and hold your balance. You can from knee up support. Where you sit. Just don't with this. From knee down, don't do anything with that. Just here up.
Just the nug.
Okay.
That makes him
that
go.
Could make it up. Hold it. And then exhale the count of five. Do that just a couple times. Now Sammy's a little nervous. He always gets a little nervous with stuff like this, but that's okay. And someone's telling us too, will you get busy and move?
Naturally crooked. And he just gets crookeder as he gets older.
You're not too top heavy. It's centered right here. Centered right there for the core. So that's why the
feet. It would be better if he could put his feet in a spine.
Yeah. I'm going to have to look for his big old boots and see if they're better.
It's a balance between being too loose and too stiff. Be too wobbly when you're fine to fall off. If you want to be so stiff with the bones, the bones are all rigid. Support. Find balance. This is why riding is so great for a lot of people.
Thank you.
See, that's not too bad. As big as he is, when I actually are connected, I see your seat is much better.
Good.
I'm glad
you're
going. Oh, you want to stop, sir?
That's an old
thing. Watch him see the video.
Yeah.
Let's give it just a few more minutes and I'll like Leah to have a ride. But I also wanted to make it long enough for you long to feel that into the movement of the horse.
Okay, I'm tightening up your above the knees.
Do you want to try the bear back then?
Like the I'm comfortable.
Bear back is great. Sam says these people don't know what they're doing. Got it. Gonna go over the board.
Easy, isn't it?
Excelente. Thank you.
hear you. Hey, boy. Hi, guy. Hello, Sammy.
Here we go.
Okay, guys, please tell everyone you know about us, especially vets suffering post-traumatic stress who might need therapy with the horses, and anyone you know, the contact information is on the screen, and we thank you.
Thank you, Sam.
Yeah, I'm going to be at work on that graph. What? Okay. We have to work on the ground too. Let's work on that instead. You know, the
long ones. Hey, buddy. Yeah, oh yeah. Uh-huh. Sam wants to bite. He wants to eat my camera.
What, baby? Oh, yeah. Okay, sweetie.
Yeah. Japanese finalist today.
Oh.
Yeah, he's learning all about he's learning Japanese, learning all about Japanese culture, history, and so forth. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, Wynn.
Come on, boy. Sam, hey.
Oh heck, why not? Makes a fitting end to the video.